this video, we are going to learn about signal flow. Signal flow is the path that the audio signal takes from the input to the output in an audio console. The signal first enters the console through an input. An input is usually a balanced signal that enters at mic level. Sometimes the signal may enter at line level, which is 50 dB higher than mic level. The input passes the signal to the preamp, which is controlled by the gain. The preamp and gain raise the signal to the correct amplitude to pass through the console. The signal then passes to the onboard dynamics. This includes your compressor, gate, limiter, EQ, expander, and de-esser. The PFL, or pre-fader listen, is used to solo a channel for listen only in the monitor headphones. The signal then passes to a channel fader, which is used to adjust that channel's specific level during live mixing. Unlike gain, which is set at the beginning and held constant through the mix, the fader is used for fine-tune adjustments during mixing. Then the signal passes through the pan, which can change the placement of the channel from left to right in a stereo mix. It also passes through a mute, which can turn off the entire signal. After the pan and mute, the signal moves to the left and right bus where it is joined, or mixed with the signal from all other channels. This is also called the main bus. A bus is a mixdown of several channels. After all the channels have been mixed, the level of the left and right bus is controlled by the master fader before the signal is outputted from the console. Once the signal from the left and right bus have passed through the master fader, the signal is then sent to the main outputs of the console to be sent to the speaker system. There are several side paths your signal can take from the main path as well, so let's jump back to the preamp. After the preamp comes the insert, where the signal can be routed through an external effect. If there is nothing plugged into the insert, the signal will bypass it. Also at this point, the signal may be routed through a preaux send. The preaux send passes the signal of all selected channels to the preaux bus, which can be routed to stage monitors or in-ear monitors. After the preaux send comes the direct output. This is often used for multi-track recording or personal monitor systems. Sometimes the signal is also routed through a postaux send, which comes after the channel fader and routes to the postaux bus. The postaux bus is used to send multiple channels to the effects. Common effects include reverb and delay. The effects are then routed to an effect return that sends the signal back to the left and right bus. Thanks for joining me today, and please check out our other church technology resources available at academyav.com.